a dentist in London laid it on George, me and our wives without telling us at a dinner party at his house. He was a friend of George's and our dentist at the time. And he just put it in our coffee or something, yeah. He was saying, I advise you not to leave, and we thought he was all trying to keep us for an orgy in his house and we didn't want to know, you know. I mean, it was insane going around London on it, and we thought when we went to the club, we thought it was on fire, and we were cackling in the street, and then, you know, people were shouting, let's break a window, you know, we were just insane. I mean, we just had our heads, and finally we got in the lift, and we all thought there was a fire in the lift, it was just a little red light, and we were all screaming like that. And the lift stops, and the door opens, and we're all going, ah! And we just see that it's the club, and then we walk in, you know, sit down, and the table's elongated. It was only a table like this, it was four of us, but it went this long. And then some singer came up to me and said, can I sit next to you? And I go, only if you don't talk! You know, like, because I just couldn't think. And then George, somehow or another, managed to drive us home in his Mini, but we were going about 10 miles an hour, it seemed like 1,000. And I was getting all this sort of hysterical jokes coming out, like a speed, because I was always on that, too. Like, oh, you know, and George would go, and you know, God, it was just terrifying, but it was fantastic. And then George's house seemed to be just like a big submarine. I was driving it, they all went to bed, I was carrying on my own. It seemed to float above his wall, which was 18 foot, you know, I was right driving them. And that's how it happened.